Make a pop up good, Jeff.
Family on three. One, two, three.
Family.
During preseason practice, the Tar Heels continue to grow together on the court, but it is not the only time players can improve. In order to achieve excellence, the type of excellence that leads to 18 Final Fours and 6 national championships, players must put in extra work outside of practice.
We got to shoot the right way, the correct way, the same way every time. And a thing that I'm really trying to instill in these guys is how hard you have to work to get better. I mean, you just cannot think you're going to be the best shooter you're going to be, whether it's at the free throw line or wherever, by just doing what is required. You got to do it before practice and after practice to have a chance to be the best that you can be. And I think the guys are doing really well with that.
Hubert Davis has been heavily involved in player development and has started implementing weekly shooting challenges.
In a week, you have to get up 500 shots for the big guys. By the end of the week, you have to get up 500 right and left-hand jump hooks, just to kind of force the guys to do more than what is required, and hopefully it'll become a habit for them to do that extra work.
One key component to this individual work is the team managers.
We're available 24/7 to the players. Marcus Page texts me, it calls me, whatever, at 10 o'clock at night. I got nothing to do, sure, I'll help him out, that's for sure. We've had a number of times, a couple Sundays in a row now, where I've helped Marcus out shooting. He's put up a lot of shots for maybe an hour and a half, 2 hours, extra shots. We had to put up 500 three-pointers, 500 makes three-pointers, and he did an extra 500. Marcus, you can see, he's doing the extra work. He got 1,000 makes.
In addition to invaluable behind-the-scenes work, the 6 team managers also chart multiple categories each practice.
Simmons make, Hubert make.
And have great insight into statistical leaders before the regular season begins.
Who sets the most screens, offensive rebounds, post feeds, turnovers. So we have a number of categories that we keep track of every practice, and every 10 practices we report those to the coaches.
Who typically has the best numbers for some of those categories?
Let's see, screens, Jackson Simmons is usually leading all the screens. I think the last time I reported to coach, he has only won over 100 screens over the course of 10 practices. Post feeds is Marcus Page. Offensive rebounds, Joel James actually is big on that category. Deflections for sure. Lately it's been Theo Pinson. He's a very good defensive player, and JP Tokotel. Those two are definitely the highest in deflections.
While the time requirements are demanding for players, managers, and coaches alike, seeing the development and results makes it all worthwhile.
I mean, that's the favorite part of my job, is getting on the court and one-on-one with a guy. I mean, there's no better feeling than to have that time with a player and just work on his game and then see it, all the hard work, see it play out and practice in a game. It's just awesome.
Sophomore Isaiah Hicks spent his first season at Carolina playing on the wing, where he showed flashes of potential. This season, he's moved back to his more natural power forward spot, where his athletic ability can be maximized.
He'd always played around the basket, around the lane, inside his whole career. We tried Isaiah on the perimeter, and he did some good things, but it wasn't his comfort zone. Now he's back. He knows when he catches the ball, he's going to be relatively close to the basket so he can shoot his jump hook or turn around jumper that he's always used his whole life. You know, he knows he's supposed to run the court right to the basket.
Run right!
Good, JP. Right to the basket. Way to run, Isaiah.
That's what Coach Williams recruited me for, because, like, in high school, that's all I did was run. So I would say that was probably, like, the best thing Coach liked about me, because I ran the floor a lot.
To help with the physicality required in the post, Hicks has continued to add muscle since arriving in Chapel Hill.
He's getting comfortable to the 20, 25 pounds that he's gained since he's been here, and that's only going to help him.
Isaiah's got all the potential in the world. He's super athletic, he's agile, he's fast, he's quick, but he's also strong.
ahead to Hicks. Isaiah to the rim! Goodness gracious, hello, young fella!
He's very impressive, and I think he's someone that everyone will be surprised by how much he's improved. He's going to be a big factor for the team this year.
You'd see the brief flash of the dunk against Louisville in Mohegan Sun, or you'd see it, but I've seen it more often of those plays. He has more ability than he's comfortable showing. I got to get him to understand you're pretty doggone good. Step out there and be more aggressive, because when you have that ability, show it. And I think that's one thing with Isaiah. He just hasn't shown that yet that he can do it, but he can.
The big man trio of Joel James, Desmond Hubert, and Jackson Simmons might not see starters' minutes, but they each provide valuable sparks to the team when their number is called.
Joel he works hard. You know, he's one of the guys that I don't have to force to do extra work. Every day, he's one of the first guys before practice working on his game. He's one of the last guys to leave after practice. He brings tremendous energy. He's one of those big guys that loves to be physical. And I think that's something that we've missed and something that we need. And I really think he can be the best defensive big guy on this team along with Desmond. I mean, he does a great job of communicating and talking. And I think when he starts to find a rhythm offensively, I think that's where Joel and his game is going to take off. But he has an unbelievable personality, so much so that everybody on this staff would adopt Joel. I mean, he walks into the room and he just makes everybody put a smile on their face.
He is quite the character, but it's also humbling too, because Joel, he works his butt off and he really cares about the game, and it is sort of infectious.
Desmond is a guy that has really worked hard this year, and I think in large part because he's a senior and he knows that time is running out. He just has, a tremendous personality. He always has a smile on his face. You look at Desmond's strengths, and his strength is that he can run. He can run like a guard. And he's 6'10".
Yeah, Desmond Hubert, very aware. I mean, he's been running the court so well on offense, sprinting down, beating everybody down there.
Probably two other guys that are just as fast as him, JP and maybe Nate. But other than that, nobody can beat Desmond. So what a huge part for us to have a big guy that can run the floor like that. I always tell the guys, you know, I don't know when it's going to be. It could be freshman, sophomore, junior, senior. But at some point, something's going to click. And you're going to get in a place where you're in a nice rhythm out there on the floor. And it's nice to see Desmond have that for a senior year.
Hello, Jackson Simmons with the floor burner.
I'll tell you what, you credit Jackson Simmons with an incredible play right there.
Jackson, another guy that just works so hard. I mean, he is in the gym all the time, and he's a Carolina kid. You know, he's a kid that wanted to be here. He wanted to be a part of the program. He wanted to get an education here. He wanted to graduate here. And those are the kids I want here, because I feel like they'll fight. They'll be invested.
He would run through a wall for Coach Williams, and then some, like, without hesitation, no question. That's a guy that plays every ounce, heart and soul, every time he steps on the floor. Between those lines, he's going to give you everything he's got.
Jackson's passion and determination are evident in his ability to make clutch plays off the bench.
During those times when your number isn't called, are you going to have the discipline to continue to work hard and prepare yourself, so that when that number is called, you're ready to go? And Jackson is a great example of that.
The time is almost here. All the weeks of running, lifting, and grinding are almost over. Just one exhibition game remains before the start of the new season.